إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، خلق الخلق حين أراد بلا معين ولا مشير، فهم على طبقات أقدارهم يمشون، وفيما قضي وقدر لهم يهيمون، وكل حزب بما لديه فرحون، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم، ما دار في السماء فلك، وما سبح في الملكوت ملك، وعلى آله وأصحابه وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. All praise to Allah. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, his blessed family, his companions and followers to the day of judgment. Brothers and sisters, the very first verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Prophet Muhammad on day one of his prophethood was, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. أمر من أول يوم للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وللمسلمين من بعده بالقراءة والكتابة بالقلم والعلم. So Allah says in close translation, on day one of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophethood, the very first beginning of this religion, read in the name of your Lord who created. He has created man from clot. Read, and your Lord is the most generous, who has taught by the pen. He has taught man that which he knew not. So it was clear from the beginning of this religion what Allah wants this nation to do was to embrace science and knowledge, to read and write. The Muslim scholars got this knowledge from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and from Quran, and started from the very early generation intensive seeking of knowledge and development of knowledge. As a matter of fact, within few centuries, Muslim scholars from early generations have played a vital role in the development of the scientific method. Muslim scholars brought this new philosophy to mankind, which is, no statement is accepted without a proof, regardless of how good that statement may be. So anyone who has a sound good statement, theory, hypothesis, we will not accept it unless he or she provides a proof, provides a fact that this hypothesis, this test, this statement passed certain tests. And that was the root of what we now know and teach our students in 101 chemistry and science, the scientific method. The foundation of scientific advancement that led to the Industrial Revolution and the modern day life as we know it now is based on that scientific method, which was created and developed by Muslim scholars long time ago. In Islamic Sharia, that proof, that test, that any statement has to pass, has to be from the Quran and from the authentic Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or from the agreement of scholars, which is always based on Quran and Sunnah. In Quran, Allah Azza wa Jalla stressed this. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين. Say, O Prophet, show me your proof if what you say is true. That's the scientific method. We have to provide the proof for what you claim. Also in Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. The general meaning is, so ask the people who have knowledge if you don't know. So if you are faced with a question, a matter, you seek knowledge according to Allah's instruction from experts in that field. You are building a house, building a bridge, you go to engineers and to civil engineers and architect. You are building a network, you go to computer engineers. You have a medical issue, you go to experts in medicine and in science and get the answer to your questions. In this following beautiful hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stressed the importance of using medicine and seeking medicine to cure yourself. قالت الأعراب يا رسول الله ألا نتداوى قال نعم ثم خطب فيهم للجميع يا عباد الله تداووا فإن الله لم يضع داء إلا وضع له شفاء. Usama bin Sharik said, some Bedouins asked, O Messenger of Allah, shall we treat our ill? He said, yes. Then he addressed the whole people then, saying, O worshippers of Allah, O servants of Allah, use medicine, for indeed Allah did not make a disease, but he made a cure for it. We have the circumstances we're talking about is known to everyone. We have a global pandemic, the COVID-19. More than 120 million people were infected and close to 3 million died worldwide from this pandemic, from this virus. Many of us have lost a friend or relative to COVID-19, and many have lost their jobs, schools are closed, and the economic and health and psychological effects are known to everyone. Question, is there a way to stop the virus transmission and end this pandemic? Luckily, and by Allah's grace, the answer is yes. The answer is yes, we can end the pandemic if most of us, about 80% of us, got the vaccine. If this happens, we will gain immunity as a society, and that will end the pandemic. So those who refuse to take the vaccine without any medical proof or any scientific proof are practically refusing to end this pandemic for everyone and will hurt the society and will hurt, they may hurt themselves, their families, and the society, because it is only when all of us, almost all of us, are vaccinated, only then we can gain the immunity and end the virus transmissions. We Muslims are the nation of Iqra, are the nation of science, logic, reasoning. Taking the vaccine will save lives, will save people from getting severe illness or from death, and will help bring some normality to our life, open the schools and open the businesses. Alhamdulillah, we live in the United States of America, and in this country, Alhamdulillah, we are blessed. We are among the fortunate because the vaccine is available here in this country, and it is free. In most of the countries, it's not. And it will take months, years, for them to get the vaccine. So we are blessed in this country because the vaccines are safe and available here for free for everyone. So it is a blessing from Allah that we have access to that, and we hope that every one of us do it, take the vaccine, and let his family take the vaccine, because it is safe and it will save not only his life, his family's life, but also others. Be thoughtful and mindful of others. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى لا سيما عبده المصطفى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran on the tongue of Prophet Ibrahim, the friend of Allah, the father of all prophets. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الذي خلقني فهو يهدين والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين والذي يميتني ثم يحيين، والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين. Who has created me and it is he who guides me, referring to Allah, Prophet Ibrahim saying. And it is he who feeds me and gives me to drink, provision. And when I'm ill, it is he who cures me. Cure is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is our faith. And who will cause me to die and then to life. Allah created us, bring us life and bring death, and cures us and will provide for us. That's our faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our faith is that cure comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our faith is also that rizq comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, this is in the heart, but we need to do our part. For example, you need to work and provide for yourself and your family. Take all the means to achieve the rizq. And similarly, we need to take all the means to achieve cure from a disease. For example, you need to provide for a family. That's number one. You rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is Al-Razzaq. He is the one who provides. And you believe in it from your heart. But that's not enough. You have to act. And you have to go to work. And you have to bring the food to the family to sustain them. Same thing with medicine. We rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whatever comes, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no cure will ever happen except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But meanwhile, we take these steps. We go to a doctor, we take the medicine. In this case, we take the vaccine and save ourselves and our families. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us, our families, and our ummah from the disease. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who are successful in this life and in the hereafter. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us, to have mercy on us, to save us, and to provide for us and for our families. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ونبيه محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أقول قبل هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.